projects, because they have problems, why not look at, they deserve to lose their potential. Forget the men, forget what men get, forget equality, men can say what they get. What can you do to simply allow potential? And I think that works. I think it works because the needs of men and women are quite different. And there, I mean, I don't remember the exact quote, but I do agree that it is setting the benchmark fairly low to simply demand rights equal to men. Because men don't really have that many rights. For example, at age 20, I spent 7 years after I was age 20, so from 27, I was a nomad in the Himalaya, living under the sky. I own horses, I did what is called extreme trekking. I was a guide on extreme treks. Cultural news, I learned, picked up several languages, most of my clients were foreigners, and I was still a nomad. I didn't own a mirror for 6 years, I didn't own a chair for 7 years. But I ate with a spoon always because my fingers had cracks, the way you see in the crack pink advertisement, but on heels, but my fingers had to, working with the horses. Which man has that? So I think there is a need to go beyond what the problem is and what the inequality is. Actually start working to see how you can leverage practical situations and make them work. You try and fight patriarchy and you call for equal rights and you try to change whole society. It's very easy to set impossible goals because then you don't have to do anything. Impossible, right? But if you actually want change, there are several things you can do. And I'm promoting the idea that there are small things you can do without, by simply changing what you do. Rather than
changing your habit.
Habit is still profound. Habit is something you do every time. I'm speaking of Abhi ki pasand hai, Abhi badal diya. Khatam. Raat bhi baad bhi. You may not do the same thing next time. Well, an example I gave is, I ride a bicycle in my area. I live in a fairly new area, which doesn't have much traffic. So, I ride a bicycle daily. I make a point of buying my cigarettes very publicly. I make a point of sitting on my bicycle, idling over it on the bicycle, talking with the vada pav next door, being very visible. I'm a woman, I'm visible doing things women don't usually do. So the next time some woman wants to do something daring, something, people say, ladke aise nahi karte, wo ladke aise karte hai, wo dekho. These are small things. Women set precedents. If you are lucky enough to have freedoms, be sure to use them. Be sure to expand them. There are other things. There are other ways you can intervene. Very often I have guests at home, and I am not one of those very gharelu bahu types. I am very certain I am an individual in my own right. And I have absolutely no hesitations asking people for help. What I do is, when there is a mixed setting, when there are men and women as guests, and I am working in the kitchen, when I ask for help, I make sure I call the man by name. Instead of, say, going into the whole pravachan about how women always have to work in the kitchen and it's high time men did something, I simply say, "Achha chalna, please can you help me in the kitchen with me?" Khatam. By name. It's a man, I chose a man. And the whole dynamic of the room has changed. It's no longer about women going to the kitchen and the mean tea and men sitting there waiting for me to come. So, I think the most effective changes are the changes that go smooth. Are the changes that happen before people realize that, oh, there is something I might oppose. Because if you may support women's rights, but if I come up and say, okay, you are unjust and you are doing this and you are doing that, and the women around you have to suffer so much, you want to say, boss, I mean, it's not my fault, I was born a man, yaar, I mean. And men may be sensitive enough to realize that there is injustice. Most men are not, and most men are actually raised with a sense of entitlement that it is their right. They do not understand that it is wrong. So if you get into that debate, then there is a whole lot of defensiveness, and was it my fault I was born a man? And what happens when you need a man? If you need a man, you need men to protect you, then why can't you serve us? Yeah. So they see it as a symbiotic relationship.
So in that case, if you start out by being extremely, say, independent, and to you and to me it's fair, but if they see it in the wrong light, and there can be a lot of repressed anger,
yes, and
if it's dangerous to you later on?
It could be dangerous. More importantly, it gets resisted. Mm-hmm. It gets resisted. And I believe resistance is a waste of time. A truly powerful person writes his will on the world. Writes his will on the world. There's no question of charcha out there. As the Marathi slang puts it. Charcha is a vishay nahi hai, asa hona hai. So how do you move beyond the conflicts? How do you move beyond the... How do you... Get into space.
Eyes open.
I am actually technically a victim of mental abuser from my husband, who is an alcoholic. I can't change my husband, so I've got to figure my life out.
No, but if somebody who's been a nomad, this thing has been fiercely independent.
That was then, this is now.
But the person doesn't change, right? That's your...
Exactly. So that's coming in useful for me. I cannot control my husband's behavior, but I can control mine.
It's all about looking at the other person like weather.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You cannot control the weather, you cannot control the other person.
Yeah.
You
so
can
I mean,
change.
My husband has not washed dishes in his home in 7 years. He has it. Okay, now I can say this is unfair that you make. He agrees with this unfair. He still wants to wash.
Yeah, most educated people are, who are otherwise very aware of what the thing is, but I'm just used to this.
No, he will not. He will say it is not fair, and I am not fair, but I'm not going to wash the dishes. It is flat out bullying. So the whole point is, he also has his problems. I have my power, he has his power. There are things I can win. There are things I could probably win if I put a whole lot of effort into it. It's probably easier to wash the utensils. So it is also about picking fights you want to fight. I can fight everything, and if you seek unfairness, there will be unfairness all over the place. It is about picking your fights. And picking your fights in a way that they make some lasting impact. अब ये बर्तन धोए क्या उसने धोए क्या मैंने धोए 15 मिनट बाद फिर से सिंक भरने वाले दिस इज नॉट वर्थ फाइटिंग इफ यू गेट माय पॉइंट आई वुड रादर फाइट अबाउट हाउ ही ट्रीट्स मी इन पर आई वुड रादर फाइट अबाउट अबाउट नॉट अप्रोचिंग मी एट ऑल व्हेन ड्रंक फिनिश ही डज नॉट डू दैट अनलेस देयर आर गेस्ट्स अट होम देन ही डज इट अंडर सोशलाइज I left him for a while, and then we got into conflicts, and I told him flat out, when you are drunk, you stay away from me. Finish. He never got to a stage where he would hit me or any such thing. We are talking of something that has been completely nipped in the bud. And that is possible because I am managing myself rather than tolerating. Me washing the utensils is not tolerating him, is me picking my battles. And I think women need to realize this, because what happens is, once this is a problem with women's rights these days, that we get off with a whole list of things. So this is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong, this is woman's problem, and it becomes
you
can't
start
too
the
big to fight. It becomes too big to fight. And there is another factor in this. There are fights which are high energy, low result. There are fights which are low energy, low effort rather, and high results. Those are the ones you want. Those are the ones you want, where you don't need to risk your life arguing with someone who might just bring a sword and run it through you. you do not want that. You do not want to be trashed by people, but you want to change minds. You want to change situations. You want to change situations so that there is no space for women. How do you do that? You will have ideas. I'll give you one. There was a person who was in a party. There were about some 8 couples, and we were deciding what to do with the evening. A few people wanted ice cream. A few people wanted to go and see a film. Rakhi was there. Everybody is drunk. Everybody is happy. And there's this woman who came up, who wanted to have ice cream, and her husband wanted to go and watch a film. And she vaguely started saying ice cream, and he kind of pichuga apan film bana. This is very common. You see it in every household. It's so common. And the simple thing I did was, okay, so 5 people want ice cream, and I think Rashmi also wanted ice cream till he shut her up. I blew it open. So that is one way you can do, is you register a small voice someone else silenced, and you make sure you voice it in a way that it won't get silenced. And that immediately stopped all further bullying of her for that evening.
That's because you heard it.
Right. So you are, what I am saying is, you could also hear. You have heard this. You have heard such talk in your life.
But not reacted.
But not reacted. That is what I am saying. So these are the moments, you know, kya bolte ho? Dekh ke mauka maro chauka, khatam. You hear that, uska koi pravachan nahi hai, uska koi lecture nahi hai, aisa mahilaon ke saath kyun baat karte ho, kuch bhi kare na. उसका ये मूड था, उसने उसको चुप कराया, पर ये हमने सुना, खत्म. आई हैव बीन श्योर टू आस्क अ पर्सन टू लीव अ पार्टी व्हेन ही अब्यूज्ड हिज वाइफ इन पब्लिक. आई डिड नॉट आस्क हिज वाइफ टू लीव. आई आस्क ओनली हिम. आई
एम श्योर शी मस्ट हैव फॉलोड हिम. शी मस्ट हैव फॉलोड हिम.
शी वाजंट इन द रूम. आई एम कमिंग इनफ फॉर दैट. And he was too insulted to stand and wait for her, so he left the room. And when she came, I told him, "Abhi bahut late ho gaya, raat ko ghar akele ban ja, we'll drop you later." This is me at work. These
did
the
discussion end there, or later when she got to know about
it? But it wasn't her fault.
She missed the picture.
That is the beauty of it. That is the beauty of being a neutral third person. You but can be irresponsible.
You will be taking many enemies of.
Yes.
I have so,
but that's a reputation, right? So they don't actually, if your reputation, people don't take it so
hard. What can you have?
If it's somebody who's not that angry.
I have a whole in public. And I say, acha, hamare ghar mein aisa baatein nahi chalti.
But for
us. You're raising a friend of ours. That's what I'm saying.
Somebody was so bad.
No, it could have had domestic repercussions
later on.
How later?
She's not told her.
She didn't
even have a defector. It's not that.
She did not ask him to leave. I saw him acting in a certain way. I did not like. I asked him to leave my house. What repercussion for her?
The question isn't that it's your fault or anything. The question is that he might think it's your fault. Either way, blame it on her.
No, it is my fault.
So he will anyway blame her, but in this specific case, she's not coming into the picture.
No, that's why his wife is not in. See, that is the bully psychology. You have to understand these things. And I'm bringing these things up because these are very interesting. If you can predict how a person will act, you can use it very usefully to create change right now. Right now. A bully, when he gets smacked, does not bring up the subject with anyone who did not see him get smacked. If his wife was not in the room, he will not bring the subject up, you know. I'm a people watcher, which is hard. See, these are very complicated things I'm doing, and it's a lot of experience from a lot of years of meddling with people. Because I have lived on my own for many years as a 16-year-old, as a 18-year-old. And I have learned to hold on to my power and make sure things happen how I want. regardless of how, and this is pure coming I'm talking about, right? It is hard earned coming. But the point is, this is, there are far many simpler things you can do. For example, asking help in the kitchen. Make sure you ask a man for man by name. You're not asking him because he's a man, but you're asking a man. So man ends up in the kitchen. The whole stereotype of a party being served by women, by men, wait for service to happen is broken, gone. Situation changed. You have a new situation in hand. So how, do you all have ideas? Do you have situations in mind where you can change a small factor in the background and change the whole thing?
Usually what happens is if the husband and wife serve, this is something which I've seen through my first time. So it's the wife is equally to blame for spoiling the habits for a person who's otherwise very rational. The guy is...
Which is fine now.
So what you do is, if the person is out of the equation, if the person who's spoiling him is out of the equation, the person still has that habit. For example, you know, I take the example of washing utensils. So if my mother is not there and you know, there's nobody else who's doing it, so it's been, suppose she's not there and me and my dad are there and you know, everybody's lazy. So you just tell the person, okay, it won't. So you do half, I do half, otherwise it doesn't get washed.
No, but he travels out of home a lot. I am at home all the time and I have a young child at home. I cannot afford an untidy kitchen for too long. I have tried leaving the kitchen untidy for weeks. He doesn't care.
It doesn't matter. It has to be where it hurts the person. Yeah.
So, like I said, there are high effort, low result, and there's low effort, high result. So, always choose the second one. You don't want to waste your effort over something that is already your right. So if you have to do 50 things, you cherry pick. If I do this, fatak
result.
If I do that, fatak. Can you identify situations? That is the question here. Can you, because having the will to do is obvious, you are sitting here, so you want to do something about it. But
similar situations happen. I experienced at workplace, okay? So 90% of people working at my company are women. And 10% are the men. But you know, we have still experienced the
decision gets made by the man anyway.
Yeah.
This is another thing you can observe.
I mean, you know, when two women in the conference room are having a healthy debate about a decision to be made and it gets ended up into a heated argument. So my boss, who's a male, would call it a catfight and would dismiss the whole thing and make his own call. And eventually, this affects...
Yes, it's where no one is debating these things. And it is very simple. It is by making people walk the talk without gambazing.
So suppose I do something that I'm in a relationship, I do something that not many women do. And then say my husband or my boyfriend and he's going and talking to a lot of other guy friends of his and saying, our women don't do such and such a thing. How come yours is doing such and such a thing? So he gets kind of, you know, pressurized. What about that in that?
I openly tell my husband friend, yaar, tum log matlab pichle zamane ke tumhare khayal aate hai. Come, you come to a modern house, behave like that. See, you command power. See, your position of power should never be up for debate. And I'm really speaking as a woman out here. If I am going to say I have been wrong like this and I'm still waiting for the men to give me my rights, that's not going to happen. Only debate about it will happen. So if someone is telling my husband stupid things, I'm going to say, usko kuch bhi bol, phir then he will break his head about it. You know, I'm going to do what I'm going to do. Why are you making a friend's life miserable? This is our talk with my husband's friends. They do things like this.
Okay, I have a question.
I suggest that they send their wives over to stay for a party.
What about the men who have been raised up to believe that it is their entitlement to such privileges?
Exactly, which is why don't argue with it.
No, I'm not. Don't